I think let me welcome all of you to our regular webinar series. Every month we have a webinar on certain topic. This time the topic is innovative temperature control solution for life sciences and health and healthcare industry in association with DHL Express. You are aware that last 1 year and a half year probably is a very tough time for all of us due to the pandemic. And I think one of the things which is most important, which was actually initially had troubles, but which was kept on, is a supply chain. I think the supply chain continued during the pandemic. That's why all of us could get the medical supplies, necessary infrastructure, which was related to the care, also could be delivered. Ancillary supplies, treatments, all these things, personal protective equipment, all could be made available because of the supply chain was maintained during this period in spite of the lot of difficulties. I think DHL is the part of this response strategy from the beginning and helping the world. There are almost 50 bilateral and multilateral collaborations with partners in both the pharma and public sector, and several new dedicated services were created to share this task. It is working in various segments. You are aware, actually, a lot of segments. DHL name is known to everybody else. So we thought this time, let us have the program, because we are seeing that the supply chain, maintaining the supply chain, particularly the cold chain and other thing, is one of the difficult target and which needs to have the innovative solutions to ensure that the drug is maintained at particular temperature during the transportation before it reaches to the hands of the doctors or the patients. And in this webinar, we will see how DHL can support cross-border movement of time and temperature sensitive shipments right from quality or R&D sample sent for testing to high volume commercial shipments. And we'll also see DHL thought leadership on sector experiences, global network capabilities, best in class infrastructure, and packaging innovation for all critical temperature ranges. We have got two people from them here. One is Mr. Rahul Singha. He's industry lead for the life sciences for the DHL. And we also have us who is going to present today is Mr. Manish Bhutani. He's a business development manager in DHL Express. He has over 12 years plus experience in the supply chain and logistic industry. Currently, Mahesh is heading the product development for the life sciences and healthcare industry with special focus on temperature control solution. We also have, I think, one more person from the DHL. I think Manish can introduce him.
Yeah,
thanks,
sure.
Manish, and I am handing it over to you to take it forward. Thank you.
Sure, okay. Thank you, Mr. Suresh, for such a nice introduction. I will share my slide and let me know if you're able to view this.
Yes, we can view very well. Make it full screen, that's all.
Yeah, I'm doing that. Yeah, so it's a combined webinar, and we have quite a few people joining from DHL, but I would like to introduce myself once again. I'm Manish Bhutani, and I'm a business development manager India for DHL Express, and I have Rajesh Singha, who's the industry development manager for life science and healthcare. Okay, and so Rajesh, so I'll be presenting. I'll be presenting today, and Rajesh and Rahul Thampi from DHL will help us to answer Q&A. So I will start with welcoming you all once again. Okay, and I will thank IPA for giving us this opportunity to present to arrange this webinar today. And I would like to specially thank Mr. Suresh Belapure and Devang Saxena for helping us throughout the process. Okay, so this presentation will go on for next 30 to 35 minutes, and then after that we have kept about 10 to 15 minutes for if you have any kind of question and answer. And with this, I would like to start the presentation with the agenda. So in agenda, we will start the presentation with some interesting facts about key achievements of life science and healthcare industry during this pandemic period over last one and a half year. What has been the challenges faced by life science and healthcare industry, especially during this pandemic time? Then what solutions which we offer, especially for temperature controlled shipments? And then lastly, we would cover that how DHL has been supporting vaccine supply chain and what does it take to deliver the vaccines across the world? So to start, some key achievements for life science and healthcare industry. Okay, although the last year it was very difficult, but we as a community has done a lot of good to the world. Starting with the total global vaccine production has quadrupled within the year. Till 2019 or mid of 2020, the vaccine production across the globe was 5 billion dosages. But come 2021, we have already reached to the 20 billion production capacity for the vaccines across the globe. And India had been a forefront in terms of capacity expansion. The complex global vaccine supply chain was ramped up successfully. And extreme cold chain requirements were met at a scale flawlessly. So there's been a lot of investment, a lot of ramp up has been done by various logistics firms to support the requirement so that the COVID-19 relief material, vaccines, medicines, treatment, medicines, etc., reaches to the patient on the time. Then vaccine rate has already outpaced the infection rate. Till April 2021, the vaccine, the number of people infected were about 65 million and there were about 550 million plus people already got their first shot worldwide. And I believe this number has reached to almost 1 billion in the month of May. Market has quickly met the demand for the testing ancillary supplies and PPE kits. So a lot of companies in the life science and healthcare space, they have ramped up the demand, ramped up the capacities so that they are able to save the lives of the people by making it sure that the supply, there's sufficient supplies of the relief material or the necessary medicines, masks, etc. Above all, COVID-19 vaccine development occurred 5 times faster than any other vaccine in the history. This graph will support this sentence, this statement. The COVID-19 vaccine has been developed in within 0.8 year of vaccine being identified. The next closest vaccine was developed within 4 years. So this is five times faster pace. The hepatitis took 16 years. HIV, we still don't have the vaccines. So this has been possible because you all from the industry has been working around the clock to save lives of the people. And I mean, and these are sincere compliments. And thank you for working around the clock relentlessly and contributing to the world. Thank you very much. Now, having looked at the stats, let's see. Now I move on to the DHL Express network capability. So in the ecosystem of life science and healthcare industry, DHL Express is a leading name. And let me introduce you to who we are with starting our, what is our network capability. We at DHL globally serving 220 plus countries with 250 plus aircraft. And we delivering 493 million shipments per year. To support this infrastructure and shipment delivery, we have about 100,000 employees working across the globe to make sure all the shipments are delivered on time. In India, we are delivering shipments in 700 and plus cities. We have 4 freighters coming in India with 19 weekly flights. We have DHL also has gateways at the major metro ports of the India and 3,200 plus full-time employees. Now, in last year, as we were discussing earlier, Rajesh mentioned at the start that DHL was the first one to start temperature control shipments after the lockdown hit us. And we all know that there has been acute belly space shortage, but DHL, because we have our own freighter network, we are being able to deliver the shipments. And in India, we have shipment freighters coming in from Singapore to Bangalore, and it moves on to Leipzig and Frankfurt. Then we have freighters coming from Hong Kong to Delhi, and it goes on to connect to Leipzig, and further these flights connect to US, and then there is a reverse flow. So with these our freighter connections, we are able to connect shipments to the major pharma markets of India and ensuring the timely delivery of all your shipments. And not only we have our freighters, but we also have a lot of tie-ups with commercial airlines, all major airlines like BA, British Airways, EK, Emirates, etc., so that we are never falling short of the space. So looking at the network, we've been working with industry closely, and we've seen the pharma industry has gone through under various challenges, and we have noted some of the challenges in this segment. There has been acute belly space shortage of all commercial airline space. As per the Air Cargo News, last year the space shortage was up to 69% due to various commercial airlines was not flying due to lockdown. There has been also a shortage in terms of active solutions and passive solutions for the packaging of temperature control shipments. Pharma is the one industry who goes through most stringent compliance and regulations, has to go through most stringent compliance and regulations. Top it all, the landed cost or the overall cost of the logistics has increased. Again, as per the Air Cargo News, that the cost has increased as high as about 61% in last 1.5 year. First and final mile delivery, due to various restrictions, government restrictions and lockdown at various places. To top it up, the shortage of manpower, there has been a lot of issues in terms of first and final mile deliveries. Okay, sustainability and carbon emission footprints is another challenge which has to be maintained. So looking at these challenges and what we have categorized some of the needs for the life science and healthcare industry. So life science and healthcare industry needs right infrastructure, you need in-house cold storage facilities, okay, and you have readily available, the need is to have a readily available packaging solutions for the temperature maintenance. Okay, connectivity, you need to have door-to-door delivery within that stipulated transit time, because these shipments always have a limited packaging validity for temperature control. Okay, then handling pharma logistics is very important. You have to have a dedicated specialist team handling pharma products, okay, and which also have a custom clearance requirement at origin and destination at both levels. Then you need a reliable partner who is able to provide sustainable solutions. And also, when the shipment is in transit, you are able to track the shipment throughout the transit at every checkpoint level. So having worked with the industry so many years, DHL has developed a temperature control solutions to suit the needs of the industry. And in this section, we will take you through what is the infrastructure which can support the movement of your temperature control shipments. To start with, we will look at what kind of temperature range we can support, so, and what products we do carry. DHL Express, we support all the temperature ranges, right from your stringent temperature ranges of minus 80 to minus 20 with dry ice, frozen, special frozen temperature range of minus 15 to minus 25, chilled temperature range of 2 to 8, and ambient 15 to 25. We have solutions for all the temperature range. Plus, there are a lot of products which we can support for the pharma sub-segment, like regulatory samples. If you want to send some dossiers with the sample for registration purpose to any of the country, or a batch sample or an API movement, or if you want to send any quality testing reference standard or working standard to any other further developing labs for a testing purpose, or if you want to import an innovative sample. So if you want, suppose import an innovative sample from US to India and you want to have a packaging support at US, so we can support the packaging there and we can bring the shipment in India, custom clear it by debiting a test license and deliver to your doorsteps. DHL is also working with a lot of CROs, clinical research organization and diagnostic firms, and we moving a lot of clinical trial movements, including biological samples and and UN3373 samples, etc. We also carrying a lot of biotechnology related materials like biosimilars or biosimilars or biologics, etc. through our network. So we're able to carry so many products through our network because we have the right infrastructure to support the logistics requirement of pharma industry. So we have ready to use inventory of packaging throughout the major pharma segments of India. So we have a range of packaging solutions available. We'll look at the range in the next coming slide. And then we can also support with the dry ice to the industry at the major locations. So, and we're the only one who have in-house cold rooms at the major locations. Plus for monitoring the temperature, the data loggers are available. So we have USB plug and play types of easy to use data loggers available where consignee can just plug into the system and download the data logger, and the readings are readily available. We provide pickup from all major postal codes of India. We also get into the white glove service at various locations. Then we have dedicated life science and healthcare team who understand the temperature controlled logistics requirement for the industry and can support the needs of the critical shipments. Moving on, with the infrastructure, we have developed the robust infrastructure and we have set up in-house cold room service and in-house cold room to our service centers. So we have five in-house cold room at our service centers located at Gurgaon, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, and Hyderabad and Bangalore. These cold rooms has 15 to 25 and 2 to 8 temperature capability range. And to support these cold rooms, we also have freezers installed which can condition the gel packs to carry temperature shipments. This picture which you see is it a real picture of one of our cold room located at Gurgaon, where our employees are assembling a softbox small pallet for one of our customer. Moving ahead, once you pack the shipment, once you have all the infrastructure, you want to move the shipment out of India. For that, you need a custom clearance. You have to have a knowledge of custom clearance and the infrastructure at the custom clearance facility as well. So DHL has own airside facilities at Bangalore and Delhi, where these facilities are our self-handling express facilities, working with customs 24/7. And some of these facilities also we have the deep freezer ranges and the refrigerators available. And with the advanced routines, we can also replenish the dry ice if there is any requirement arises during the custom clearance. So you have infrastructure, you have clearance facilities, but one more thing you need is the right team to handle this shipment. So we have DHL Express, working in the industry over a period, has developed a control tower process for all the temperature control shipments, where this control tower is involved right from the shipment planning stage, where if you're sending a new inquiry, the team is up and they will, basis the product capability, they will suggest you the right packaging in case of passive requirement. We work basis our SOPs, will be able to give you quote, and once the shipment is picked up, you will get all the notifications proactively at every step of a shipment lifecycle. Apart from that, to support the control tower, we have regional QCC teams monitoring the shipments throughout the line haul, so that if there is any contingency, this QCC centers alerts our control tower, and the control tower then gets into the service recovery and the crisis management mode. So this is the biggest advantage, that you know, the dedicated life science team who understands the product, they will work as a center stage for all your temperature control shipments. So moving on, to move the temperature control shipment, you need either an active packaging solution or a passive packaging solution. There has been quite a few shortage during last one and a half year in the active packaging solution range. So over a period, we have come up with a various portfolio of passive range, which is readily available on demand for, you know, all your requirements. And these passive range is available in the pallet sizes as well, to substitute the active range of you know, of shipments. And not only the major not only the bigger shipments, we also support a lot of small sample movements, likes of your stability testing sample or R&D sample. So and we can support the passive packaging requirement for that. So we have packaging range as small as product space liter of 0.25 liter to 1200 liter. And this is available in all the temperature ranges, 15 to 25, 2 to 8, minus 20 plus minus 5, or a minus 80 to minus 20 environment. And to add up all, we have the passive packaging portfolio of 45 plus packagings with validity as high as 168 hours. So if you want to reach to the locations, the farther locations like Africa or Latin America, I mean, we can reach through our network with this higher validity packaging ranges. Apart from that, for supporting the commercial shipments requirement, we have pallet range, which has a liter capacity of 264 liters to as high as 1200 liters, and with the validity of 120 hours. And these pallets are available in the PCM as well as traditional gel packs ranges as well. So having talked about our infrastructure, packaging infrastructure, now you know, we'll just would like to give you few pointers on how we've been supporting the world with our for the vaccine movements. So just to give you some stats, the world would need 10 billion plus vaccinations to immunize 70% of the population to achieve the herd immunity. So there is a 7.8 billion of global population. And to achieve the herd immunity, you need 70% of the people to be vaccinated. So on an average, per person will need 1.8 doses. To add it up, you will need total 10 billion vaccines. To move 10 billion vaccines around the world, you will need 2 lakhs pallets, pallet shippers. You will need 15 million deliveries in cooling boxes, and you will need 15,000 plus flights. And the complexity does not end here. The various vaccines are made on the different platforms, which need different temperature ranges. Like some need more stringent temperature norms of minus 70, minus 20. Some will need more conventional temperature norm of 2 to 8. But with DHL Express globally, we are able to serve all the temperature ranges and deliver the vaccines. And I'm happy to announce here that we have been the trusted partner of COVID-19 vaccines, and we have been the first one to deliver first lot of vaccine to various countries. You can see the examples of Singapore, Malaysia, Israel, Sri Lanka, and including India, we have been the first of the lots. And on the key contributions, we have delivered about 1,200 million doses internationally across the world. 120 plus countries are served. Okay, 9,000 plus flights operated to deliver these vaccines. 350 plus DHL facilities were involved, and 50 plus collaborations were done with pharma and public sectors. We have also set up 10 new dedicated facilities services to make sure that we deliver these critical vaccines timely. Moving on to now. To summarize that, why you should be using DHL for temperature control solution is that we have faster transit time with the help of our own aircraft freighters. We have 45 plus best-in-class packaging solutions, dedicated life science team, which works as a control tower for your temperature control shipments, in-house cold room facilities. The infrastructure is robust. Complete visibility. So you will have a complete visibility of your shipment throughout the transit. So you get peace of mind while shipment is getting delivered. A range of solutions. So with this, we become your one-stop shop solution provider that we DHL can support life science industry right from sending a sample or a quality testing product or a dossier for registration to your commercial shipments, to your API shipments with the stringent temperature norms. To top it up, we also, above all, we provide one invoice. We'll provide one invoice for the complete door-to-door delivery. Then all the invoices will be in INR, so you are safe from the currency fluctuations. And we can get into the long-term contract as I has for 1 year, for all your temperature control all your logistics requirements. So with this, I end my presentation. Thank you all for attending. We are open to any questions and answers now. These are my contact details. You can reach out to me as well at any point of time for any help required on our side. So thank you very much once again. We are open now for taking any questions.
Thanks, Manish. So I've got a few questions in the chat. Shall I take it, the first question?
Yeah, Rahul, go ahead.
Yeah, so we have two questions on the temperature excursions. One is from Mr. Gohar Raja, Natco Pharma, and another one is from Vikrant. So I'm just clubbing both the questions. So the question goes like this. We are facing temperature excursions during the transit and when the shipment is at the tarmac while the presence of other goods. So how to overcome the temperature excursions during the transit, and how will you ensure that the temperature excursions can be avoided? And another question in relation to this is, what are DHL data loggers, and what is the price of DHL data logger?
Who's this question from? Natco Pharma.
Yeah, Mr. Gohar Raja, Natco Pharma, and and Mr. Vikrant.
Okay, so thank you, Mr. Gohar and Mr. Vikrant, and it's a very valid question, especially during one and a half year, the airline cutoff has increased, and you have seen sudden spike in the temperature excursion, especially when the shipment is waiting for the connection and on the tarmac. So as I mentioned in my presentation, that we have a control tower process. So we plan a shipment in such a way. So and this has become a part of our shipment planning. We plan shipment in such a way that there is a minimum stoppage of shipment at any point of time, and the line haul is designed in such a way so that shipment will not be held at anywhere in during the transit. And because we have our freighter connection, so the cutoff for the tarmac is very, very, cutoff time is well under control. So avoiding any temperature excursion requirement, excursion possibility during this period. The data loggers, on the question of data loggers, sir, we do provide data logger. I mean, we provide all-in solutions where, you know, once you give us a packaging, once you give us a shipment or you raise an inquiry with us, we will support with the passive packaging, suitable passive packaging, data logger, pickup, and line haul. So we'll provide you one all-in cost for your door-to-door delivery, including packaging, data logger, pickup, line haul, clearance, everything will be included in that. Hope I'm able to answer the question.
Thanks, Manish. Shall I move to the next question?
Yeah, Rajesh, you want to add up anything on these?
Yeah, so Manish, you have rightly covered and you have rightly shared that the processes and the global SOPs with DHL runs is primarily just in time, you know. So our waiting time at various touch points is the minimal, which allows less of exposure into tarmac. So that's how we have been managing our shipments. And we take the shortest possible transit available in that country. So, you know, if you are moving shipments into Europe, our flights move directly from Delhi and Bangalore into Europe, so which is the shortest transit time available. And that's how you are, you know, having less of transits and direct connections. So this is one of the USP which DHL has been operating in, and obviously our world-class packaging, which we have designed to support our network, which we are operating. And in today's pandemic situation, what people want is an assured connection. So our freighters, which is 19 weekly flights, which is coming into India, ensures that all pharmaceutical and temperature controlled shipments are moved immediately as it is, you know, picked up from our customers and processed out of the country ASAP. We have also built up a lot of capabilities in handling vaccine shipments. To name a few, and I'm sure a lot of people will be interested to understand more that what is DHL Express plan to handle vaccine shipments. So I'm happy to share that the customs have allowed express companies to handle vaccine shipments in their terminal. So what does it mean for our customers? It means when your shipments will be exported out of the country or you are importing into India, DHL will be able to clear their shipments once it lands into their own terminal. So Manish had just shared that we have built up a new gateway in Bangalore, which has 96,000 square feet of processing area. So imagine if you have a vaccine shipment coming from Europe and it lands into Bangalore, you know, there is enough space to handle it. We will, you know, file for pre-clearance because it is our own terminal. We can work with, you know, validated SOP and file in advance so that the shipment comes and immediately leaves the terminal post-custom clearance. So this is the best thing which can happen for us in India, you know, just-in-time clearance, pre-filing, and all this has been planned in last 2 years. We have been constantly working with our customers to understand what kind of supply chains need, the vaccines will require. So, you know, we have built in the capability to replace dry ice in all our major gateways. And the most stringent requirement of the -50, -25 vaccines, which has been recently scaled up. In this temperature range, we have worked with our packaging partners and developed packaging which can sustain this temperature range. You know, we are happy to share that last 2 years, DHL have been constantly working with various partners in the industry, in the packaging side, to build this world-class solution. And we are ready to handle any kind of, you know, temperature range which will be required by the industry, which Manish has also covered in his slide. So these are the unique things which makes a DHL door-to-door proposition and unique in the industry.
Thank you, Rajesh. So another question we have from Mr. Ghanshyam. The question goes like this. He wanted to understand Europe to Mumbai, the routing, and how do we ensure the thermal data in whole transit? And also, he has mentioned in the bracket that currently he is using two service providers for getting shipment from Europe countries, Europe Union to Mumbai, using one logistics service provider. And again, from after clearance, from Mumbai port to his company, he's using another logistics service provider. So we want to understand how are we going to handle Europe Union to India routing, and how do we ensure the data, thermal data also.
Okay, So Mr. Ghanshyam, I think so for handling shipment movement from Europe to India, I think we have our own freighters coming in from Europe to India, and we have freighters coming in directly from Leipzig, and it's landing in Delhi, and also we have one more freighter coming into India, landing at Bangalore. So these shipments will be handled through our, I mean, freighters, and to land in India, and we have our own, I mean, custom clearance airside facility where these shipments will be custom cleared and delivered to you. How do you ensure the thermal data is mentioned? I mean, it's based on the requirement, and we can get in touch with you and discuss on these points. Basically, this will depend on what is the requirement. If it is a passive packaging, then we can arrange a passive packaging at the origin and connect the shipment to India with the packaging. Or if you want any unique module where, you know, to be developed around that, I think we can get in touch and speak on that.
Also, Manish, he has mentioned that he is using two service providers for a door-to-door movement. One is door-to-port and then port-to-door.
Yeah, so I mean, that's perfectly fine. I think we can work on the routings and the Incoterms, maybe door to door or door to port. We can manage both the ends. If you want the shipment to be cleared, we bring in the shipment to India, we hand over the DO to you, and you want to clear the shipment through your CHA, I think that's also possible.
And just to add to what Manish has said, you know, so we can work with you, sir, and understand your lane. What we do is a kind of a lane validation. So first we will do a lane validation, we will understand your transport guidelines and accordingly build a solution. And most important thing, that DHL has been focusing on door to door. It is like one service provider which is all the way, and which is the need of your supply chain requirements, and we'll be happy to connect with you further and discuss more post the session. Please reach out to us or share your contact details in the chat box, and we will reach out to you in person to do a transport study for you and offer you a seamless solution for your supply chain requirements.
Okay. Thanks, Ajish. There's one more question. Mr. Bharat is asking, are these boxes reusable? So Mr. Bharat, we have mix of boxes. So it's a single use and reusable. Both the type of packagings are available with us. And we work as per the requirement you have.
Right. So there's a follow-up question from Mr. Raja. So he has shared his experience here with the previous service provider. The feedback given by service provider was the shipment was kept near the flight engine, which was the reason for excursion. So how can we avoid such incidents?
Okay, I'll answer that question, Manish.
Yeah.
So sir, this is a very... very common question which I get to hear from our customers, and there is no standard solution for this challenges you face during the transport. You know, a couple of observations, and which I am sharing. Why I'm saying observation is it's a guidance, but we would like to work with you, understand your transport stability, understand your transport guideline, and then we can zero down the solution. But what we have seen is, you know, there is a difference between moving shipments in dedicated cargo flights and passenger aircraft. Now, please understand that when you're using shipments moving in a cargo freighter, your shipments are inside the freighter and then the engine is switched on. Okay. But generally, when you use a passenger aircraft in the tarmac, this is our observation and this is our personal opinion about it. And what we have seen is, so generally, when my shipment is waiting in the tarmac, there might be other flights which are, preparing to move. And, this leads to a change in the temperature of the airwaves, which leads to these kind of situation. But yes, we can connect with you and understand how you have routed your shipments, what kind of, transits you have taken, how many transshipment the cargo had. And, we will be happy to work with you and look at a solution for your requirements.
Thanks, Rajesh. I'll move to the next question. What is the current condition of air movements within India? The question is from Rahul from Sun Farm.
Okay. So, sir, today you know there is a crunch in the air capacity everywhere, internationally as well as within the country. And this is where, you know, DHL and its group companies, which are under the DPDHL umbrella, is working very closely with the industry to offer solutions. So in DHL, how it happens is we have our international flights, which are coming into our international gateways. And we have block space arrangement with all the leading, domestic aircrafts in India, airlines in India. And we also have a group company, Blue Dart, who operates dedicated freighter. So with the combination of the best available solution for our customer, we are able to address this situation in the industry. And in case, if you have some challenges of space in any lane, please do reach out to us. We will be happy to find some space, because life science and healthcare is very, very critical and close to our heart. And we are constantly working to support our customer and, give them the best solution in the current times.
Thanks, Rajesh. Next question is from JB Chemicals and Pharmaceuticals. So they have contrast media products which should be kept away from secondary X-ray radiations. So the storage requirement is included in the product label itself on the outer box. So they wanted to know whether we'll be able to ship these products without X-ray screening at the port.
Rajesh, you want to take it?
Yeah. So, sir, this is a very unique requirement which you have posted as a query to us. To tell you very honestly, I don't have an answer for you right now, because any shipment which leave the country has to do its due diligence of whatever is the customs guideline. This is a question, if it is, really affecting your supply chain, we will be happy to connect with you. We will work with our head of regulatory affairs in India, along with your compliance team. And, obviously we have to work with the industry and the regulators to see what is the best available solution. If this is life-saving and critical, I'm sure we can form a, working group and find a solution to your logistics and supply chain requirement.
Okay, thank you. There is one more question from Vikrant Baje. Please share solutions available for 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, minus 15 to minus 20 degrees Celsius, minus 50 to minus 80 degrees Celsius. So Mr. Vikrant, please leave your contact details with us and we will get in touch with you and we'll share these solutions available, the right solutions available with DHL, and we can work together on that, sir.
Thanks, Manish. Next question is from MQ. Is it allowed to bring Envirotaino at the factory?
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
Is it allowed to bring Envirotaino at the factory? Question is from Abhinash, MQ.
Mr. Abhilash, I think it depends. Avinash, it depends on which airline, which Envirotaino we are using. I think it will have to be handled on a case-to-case basis. Some airline usually restrict moving Envirotaino going out of the airport, and then the shipment has to be moved through a temperature control vehicle. But nowadays we have certain alternative solutions available, like passive ones or the Vacutainer ones, which can be moved through to the doorstep. But it again depends on the packaging, which on the type of Envirotainer or the packaging or the airline we are using. So I think it will be better if we get in touch with you and talk on the specific requirements.
That's all, Manish, the questions in the chat.
There is one more question, Mr. Rajiv Thakur. I would like to know, how are you dealing with the temperature excursions during the transit, or what are the controls? Rajesh, you want to answer this? Excursions?
Yes, so sir, obviously excursions are a part and parcel of the cold chain and temperature control solution industry, and you know, you can never be 100% correct. But what we do is, in case an incident happens, the incident gets, you know, obviously we have a team who at the back end works to understand the incident, go through the every touch point, you know, from pickup till the delivery, understand the, you know, the temperature, the factors, the kind of handling, routing. So there are a lot of factors which get assessed, and those are then put into a study. And based on that, we find the solution which can be implemented in the next movement for the shipments. So there is no standard answer to this, you know, that I will do A plus B and I will get an answer this. There is no standard answer. It has to be looked at the shipment, the transport data, and then looked at what are the external factors, or, you know, controllable and uncontrollable factors which needs to be addressed and how it can be addressed. We in DHL have a system where we read this along with our team. We have a customer operations group team. We have a dedicated customer service team who constantly work with the network to understand these factors and look at options to mitigate these kind of, you know, external factors which might affect such situations.
Yeah. Yeah. Just to add, sir, we put all our efforts are in line that the excursion should not happen in any of the shipment, and we should be able to minimize the excursions. And if something happens, then we have a procedure and we prepare a CAPA. We submit the CAPA with you, and you know, agree the preventive action, and you know, and put it, and our preventive actions are put into SOPs, and we follow the SOPs accordingly. Obviously, as Rajesh highlighted, it happens for controllable and non-controllable factors. But yeah, this is how we follow. We prepare a CAPA and we submit the CAPA. We agree the CAPA with your quality team, and you know, and then we put the practices into. We put the preventive action into practices and monitor it for the shipments.
Okay, I also see one question from Mr. Vikrant Barje, where he shared, please share the solution available in 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, -15 to -20 and -50 to -80. Sir, we are happy to share with you that whatever temperature ranges you require, DHL has been working on these temperature ranges, and we have enough and more experience to cater to your needs. And Manish has already shared that, you know, we have the packaging ranges which are available to support your requirement. And one of our biggest development during this requirements of vaccine transportation is the -15 to -25. And we are happy to share that, you know, we have worked with our partners and develop these solutions in India, which is available in India, and we can scale up to capacity if you need, you know, let's suppose 150 pallets every month. Our partners have the capability to offer those solutions for -15 to -25 degree, and these are stable up to 120 hours. We have been testing this packaging for almost more than a year now, and the results are really good. If anyone is interested in more about this packaging, please reach out to us, because this packaging has become the most important temperature range with the vaccines coming in. Earlier, I can share with my experience, you know, the requirement was very limited with respect to some APIs or some kind of an, you know, intermediaries or some R&D activity. But now with vaccines, the demand has gone up for this packaging. And let me tell you, sir, this is in real solution which all the packaging provider has developed. And we have partnered with one of the leading packaging provider, a global packaging provider, and built it as a solution available, which can handle vaccine shipments starting from 5,000 dosages and can be scaled up to 50,000 dosages, you know, under one airable or one packaging. So all the ranges are available. And there are, I would like to mention a special kind of packaging which we have developed, something called the narrow body pallet. You know, it really works for all those kind of aircrafts which are smaller in size. You know, today DHL has developed all the kind of packaging range which will be able to manage all kind of trade lanes. So starting from a small box to a, you know, narrow body pallet to a small to a medium and a large, so we can handle them, we can offer the right solution and do a lane study. This is available and we are happy to share. Please reach out to us or share your contact number in the chat. We will reach out to you, Mr. Vikrant, to manage your requirements.
Manish, can I ask one question?
Yeah, Mr. Shirish, why not?
Manish, I think these are the standard packs developed for each of these temperature ranges, and these are for the air or for the sea shipment also. These are mainly for the air shipment, right?
Yeah, so the passive solutions which we kind of showcase was for the air shipments, because we delivering, we are primarily into air express network, door-to-door air express network. So all the solutions which we've shown throughout our presentation for air express delivery.
Okay. Yes. And sir, we would also like to add to what Manish has shared, a dry ice is another requirement which is required to carry vaccines in and out of the country, or any kind of clinical trial blood samples. And we also have that capability to manage dry ice shipments into India. So if you want to import any kind of biological samples or vaccines in dry ice, DHL is the partner of choice for this. And we have developed these solutions. If someone has a requirement, they can reach out to us. We can do a lane study and offer the dry ice movement into the country till the last mile delivery. So we have been doing all these kind of capability studies and built up and solution development in last more than a year now.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. I just wanted to, in addition to my question, one question I asked was whether these are the standard packs or the standard type of packaging for the minus 20 degrees centigrade, 228 degrees centigrade, minus 75, or it is custom built totally.
So I mean, very valid question, sir. So first thing is that some of these solutions are obviously standard, which is available in the industry, but there are many solutions like, Rajesh spoke about the narrow body pallet. These are very niche solutions, and even your minus 20 range, or even some solution which I mentioned in the presentation of 160 TAS plus, which gives a validity of 160 TAS plus. I mean, these are some of the solutions which we have developed over a period, looking at the customer, the industry requirement, and working closely with our vendors. Okay. And we've reached to the level that now, we are going into the sort of pharma customers and offering these niche solutions as well on the larger scale.
I think it was a very interesting session, and the presence there was also good. It shows the importance of the supply chain and the interest the topic has generated overall.